Hi there, I'm here with Louis and Catherine, who are at Matthews and Canaday respectively. They're both freshmen, and they're here to talk a bit about their project, WriteRight. So Louis, maybe we'll start with you. What inspired this project? What does it do, man?
So I was with our other third group member in office hours in Wider Sunday, the night the project implementation was due, and we were thinking of very cool ideas, and all of a sudden we came up with this idea of implementing this whiteboard where you can draw images and then hopefully reverse Google image search. And so it was really an idea that just came out of trying to do something fun and also very memorable.
Fantastic. And Catherine, could you like show us how it works?
Yeah, for sure. So working along with Sava Thurber, who is our third group member, we created a website, which I'll demonstrate to you here. Right here. And if you look at our website over here, first users will want to register with their login page. And after they're registered, you'll log in. After logging in, you will see our functionality. So on the right, we have a whiteboard. And you'll see this pop up over here for WriteRight. You can, users are allowed to draw on the whiteboard. You can also change the color of your whiteboard. So let's say we want this lovely green shade over here. You can also change the brush size for your whiteboard, generate random images, and you can also write in text boxes, which will import your text onto here. So the goal of this project after this point is, let me show you some a little bit more functionality from our actual digital. So you can import text here. So let's say I wanted to say hello. You can see that hello pops onto the screen along with different sizes of that, and you can also generate random images. So after this point, our goal was to be able to save the image to your computer and then send it through another file, which would then reverse image search it. Unfortunately, we weren't able to really get all the parts to mesh together, but individually all of them work really cohesively. After importing a specific image into our reverse image search code, then you get the top five images that match back.
Guys, this is an incredible project. It looks really, really good. You know, if you had more time, I'm sure it all would have come together. But I wanted to ask, for future students who are going to be taking the course, when they're thinking about their project, like, what sort of advice would you have in terms of thinking about the idea and actually getting the project done?
Definitely recommend picking an idea that you would find very memorable and very fun to present to all your classmates and friends in this fair. And also definitely go to office hours right from the beginning to make sure you have a good setup for your project.
Yeah, I'd say I agree with Louis and really find time to like sit down and flesh through the brainstorming portion of it. I think that was what set us up for success the best. We really wanted to make sure we had all of our portions divvied out well, and then from there we focused on how we could actually integrate them all together, and that made for a very smooth project management portion, and we didn't run into any hiccups there. Yeah, definitely super exciting, and it was great working with Louis and Sava on this wonderful project.
Guys, thank you so much for your time. It's a great project, and this is CS50.